He served in two world wars, spent 4 years as a prisoner, and lost his son in the fighting. Charles Mainstone is one of our ANZAC heroes. Now, with the last of our great war veterans gone, the next generation is making sure their stories live on.
It's 1915. The Great War is raging. Here in Sydney, 15-year-old Charles Mainstone puts up his hand.
This is my father here, Dick. You see, very, very young.
Lying about his age, he marched off to Gallipoli and suffered the effects of mustard gas while serving on the Western Front. One of the lucky ones who lived to bring home his souvenirs.
He carried that with him right through the war.
Returning to Earlwood with well wishes from the King.
The Queen and I wish you Godspeed and a safe return to the happiness and joy of home life.
Charles married Phyllis, along came five children, Merv, the youngest son. Then war broke out again.
I can vividly remember sitting down and listening to Robert Menzies, the current Prime Minister, announce that Australia was at war.
And Charles Mainstone needed a job.
He put his age up to join the First World War, and then he put it down to join the Second World War.
Now elevated to Staff Sergeant and deployed to Greece.
The Germans captured him and many others in Crete, and that was in June 1941.
A prisoner of war, Charles captained the camp's cricket and footy teams to pass the long 4 years.
It only focused on the good times. What they did, you know, when they had entertainment and stuff.
With their father in captivity, Merv's oldest brother Charlie joined the effort, and a year into his service, he too was captured.
And he was on the Sandarkan death march, and he died in March of 1945, not long before the war ended.
Finally, peace came and Charles was released.
I can remember him coming back. I certainly remember when he came back. Joy all around.
Like so many families, the Mainstones pause every ANZAC Day to remember. On Thursday, thousands will gather here for a service at the newly renovated Hyde Park War Memorial.
I watch the march, and I do get a bit dewy-eyed during it.
Keeping his family's legacy alive. Liz Daniels, 9 News.